Savadi crap to everybody out there. Creative Thoughts series, Raising River Cast Kitchen Table. In today's episode, I'm building the mold for an epoxy cast kitchen table. Before jumping to it, if you think I deserve, of course, please subscribe to my channel and ring the bell for future videos notification. And now, with that being said, let's to build some and let's to have fun with! Okay guys, with the rubbing alcohol, I'm cleaning this plywood sheet 2 cm thick. This is the third episode of my Creative Thoughts series, and I'm building an epoxy river cast kitchen table. And today I'm crafting its mold. This plywood sheet is the mold base. If you are interested in how I ended up to this point, above my head, web link to the playlist of this series. Raising River Cast Kitchen Table. With the scotch tape, I'm going to wrap all the mold base. Epoxy, once cured, won't stick to plastic smooth surfaces. Scotch tape is the effective, proper way to deal with a resin mold. It makes our life much easier. Once the table will be assembled, epoxy cured, it will release from the mold with a mild lift push force. With the scrap wood strips 5 cm wide, I build the mold sides. I already cut the strips to the desired length. I'm going to fix in place the mold sides with the glue and screws. So let's begin by drilling holes with my crack pocket holes jig. Speed up the process, better to use my bench vise. Let's clean the mold sides first, then, as I did for the mold base, I wrap the mold sides with the scotch tape. Don't skip this step, please. Once epoxy will be cast and cured, coat the scotch tape, the table will release from the mold easy, just a mild lift and will be free from the mold. As I said earlier, epoxy doesn't stick to plastic smooth surfaces as scotch tape. Any plastic scotch tape goes, will be perfect for the job. My workbench is perfectly flat. Actually, I'm using my Surface flattening sled base as a workbench, and I know that it's 100% flat. Just to be sure, let's check one more time the flatness of the table. The surface must be 100% flat for obvious reason to ensure epoxy casting spreading apart uniformly. Let's glue in place the mold sides. I'm using 1000 nails glue. Everything should be in order. Let's check one more time. Corners are square, okay? So I can finally screw the mold sides in. Last step of the process, seal all the edges with silicone. I'm applying an abundant quantity of silicone to seal all the edges, preventing troubles later on, better to avoid epoxy spilling out and the consequent big mess. Let's remove dust, if any. And here I am, job is done. I'm going to give 2 fully days to silicone to cure, harden properly, and in the next video, the most exciting fun part of the job, resin cast. In the meantime, thank you very much for watching and see you soon. Bye bye!